India Legal presents Court This Week.
Hello, I am Dusha West and you are watching Courts This Week. In this program, we bring you the roundup of legal news and details of the court's proceedings of the week. A plea has been filed before the Supreme Court seeking directions to the centre and states to take appropriate steps to double the number of judges in the high courts and subordinate courts and implement a judicial charter to decide the cases. Here's a report.
The PIL filed by Advocate Ashwini Kumar Upadhyay has sought directions to the centre and states to implement the recommendations of Law Commission Report number 245 and take other steps in order to break even and dispose of the backlog in a three-year time frame. According to the plea, the Apex Court, being the custodian of the Constitution, and shall issue proper directions for implementation of the judicial charter in all the courts to decide the cases within 3 years and to break even and dispose of the backlog by 2023. The plea has stated that the right to fair trial and speedy justice is a fundamental right under Article 21. Therefore, no procedure can be fair unless it ensures fair and speedy determination of guilt of the accused. Fair trial and speedy justice have been recognized as an inherent and implicit aspect in the spectrum of Article 21. In order to provide speedy justice to ordinary citizens, there is urgent need to reform the judicial system. Requires that justice should not only be delivered on time but also be easily accessible to people, particularly people from vulnerable sections of society. A thorough understanding of current shortcomings and future needs of the system must guide the approach to reform. The plea says that the process of reform must begin with an assessment of the country's need that the legal profession seeks to fulfill, namely the requirements across various levels of judiciary, gaps in criminal justice system, specific areas within the law which will require an increased number of practitioners in the near future. As part of judicial reforms, the lawyer community, which has often been ignored, should also be considered. Legal education and continuing professional development must create a socially sensitive lawyer of conscience, from where justice delayed is not an opportunity but a blemish on one's personal persona and a failure of the system of which one is an integral part. A similar plea was filed by Upadhyay in 2016 seeking court's direction to the centre to double the number of judges in the country, which was disposed of by the Apex Court with liberty to the petitioner to approach the court again. Bureau report.
In a curious development, a judge of Andhra Pradesh High Court has passed an order with critical observation against the proposal made by the Supreme Court Collegium to transfer the Chief Justices of High Courts of Andhra Pradesh and Telangana. In an order passed by Justice Rakesh Kumar, sought to draw a connection between the transfer proposal of the Supreme Court Collegium and the bombastic letter shot by Andhra Pradesh Chief Minister Jagan Mohan Reddy to the Chief Justice of India with allegations against the state judiciary, while adding that he was not raising any questions at the collegium proposal. Justice Kumar observed that transfer of High Court judges or its Chief Justice may reflect some transparency. After all, they are also holding constitutional posts like member of Honorable Supreme Court Collegium, he added. Justice Kumar observed that by sending the unceremonious letter to the CJI, the Chief Minister has succeeded in getting undue advantage at the present moment. These observations were made by Justice Rakesh Kumar while rejecting an application made by the state government seeking his recusal from a division bench hearing a case. The Advocate General alleged in the application that Justice Kumar had taken a biased stand against the government. It was alleged in the application that Justice Kumar made an oral observation during a previous hearing that we will declare there is breakdown of the constitutional machinery in this state and hand over administration to the central government. Certain newspaper reports were annexed with the application to support the allegations that the judge had made such oral remarks. However, Justice Kumar denied making any such remark and said that he was merely expressing doubts about the legality of the move of the government to auction public land for private bidders. He rejected the allegations of bias and came down heavily on the government for seeking his recusal. In the ETA advocate assault incident, Allahabad High Court has ordered magisterial inquiry. Chief Judicial Magistrate will do the inquiry and will submit a complete report on or before the next date of listing. Here's a report.
The Allahabad High Court sought a complete report of the incident wherein Rajendra Sharma, a practicing advocate at ETA, was beaten and manhandled by police, and his relatives too were harassed and humiliated. The bench of Chief Justice Govind Mathur and Justice Soumitra Dayal Singh has directed the Chief Judicial Magistrate, ETA, to inquire into the matter and submit a complete report on or before the next date of listing. As per the court's order, the Chief Judicial Magistrate, ETA, has been directed to make necessary inquiry by availing all relevant facts, including audio-visual electronic documents, and submit to this court on or before next date of listing. Further, the District Magistrate, ETA, as well as Senior Superintendent of Police, ETA, have also been directed to cooperate and supply all relevant facts and documents as desired by the Judicial Magistrate, ETA, to furnish report of the incident to this court. The order of Allahabad High Court has specifically acknowledged the letter sent by the Bar Council of Uttar Pradesh, which was addressed to the Chief Justice of the Allahabad High Court with a request to take appropriate action in relation to this incident. The court's order also mentions that a letter was received by the Secretariat of the Chief Justice from the High Court Bar Association relating to same issue, and that certain other advocates also agitated the cause through email. The Allahabad High Court took suo motu cognizance of this incident and the matter was listed for today. Significantly, the Bar Council of India has already issued a statement condemning the police assault and had urged the Chief Justice of the Allahabad High Court and the Chief Justice of India to take suo motu cognizance of the same. While requesting the CJI and CJ of Allahabad High Court to take actions, the BCI had also added that its request was not considered by Uttar Pradesh government. The SCBA also condemned the police assault. Also taking a serious note of this incident, the High Court Bar Council, Allahabad, had sent a letter requesting the Chief Justice of Allahabad Court to take suo motu cognizance of the said incident and pass appropriate orders to maintain the law and order situation of the state. Bureau Report.
The gratuity money of an employee can be withheld and forfeited for recovery of dues such overstaying in official accommodation, the Supreme Court has ruled. A bench headed by Justice Sanjay K. Kaul held that there is no prohibition against recovering dues, including penal rent, the rent with penalty for overstaying in official accommodation from an employee's gratuity. Here's a report.
The Supreme Court has observed that a gratuity can be withheld for recovery of dues from an employee. In this case, the Jharkhand High Court had rejected the contention raised by Steel Authority of India Limited that the company was entitled to withhold the gratuity of the employee from its retired employee. In this case, the Jharkhand High Court had rejected the contention raised by Steel Authority of India that the company was entitled to withhold the gratuity of the employee for non-vacation of the company's accommodation and no interest was payable on the same. The High Court has relied on 2017 Supreme Court judgment in Ram Naresh Singh versus Bokaro Steel Limited and others case. The court added that the reliance placed by the High Court on the case of Ram Naresh is misplaced, that it was not even a judgment but an order in the given fact of the case. In the said order, the court had held that Bokaro Steel Limited could not be retained the amount due to its employee on account of gratuity. In the said order, the court had held that the Bokaro Steel Limited could not have retained the amount due to its employee on the account of gratuity. The court, however, dismissed the writ petition, observing that the amount in question is also quite small and thus it is not a fit case for interference under Article 136 of the Constitution. The order settles a disputed point of law since the two-judge bench of the Supreme Court had previously taken a view to the contrary. A division bench in 2017 had ruled unfavorably against confiscating the gratuity of an employee on account of overstaying in official quarters after his retirement. It had ordered the immediate release of his gratuity and held only normal rent, not the penal rent, should be charged for the period he overstayed. However, the three-judge bench led by Justice Cole has now held that any reliance on the 2017 order is misplaced. Since it is not even a judgment but an order on the given facts of the case, it clarified that the 2017 order cannot be treated as a precedent. The latest case has arisen out of an order by the Jharkhand High Court which snubbed an attempt by the State Authority of India to recover penal rent amount amounting to Rs 1.95 lakh from an employee who did not clear his dues and overstayed in the official accommodation in Bokaro after his retirement in 2016. Mirror Report.
The Kerala High Court has passed a judgment holding that the All India Council for Technical Education, AICTE, has the power to prescribe mode of recruitment for maintenance of standard of technical education, but it is not empowered to bring in regulation with retrospective effect. Here's a report.
Kerala High Court given a judgment holding on All India Council of Technical Education. The division bench of Justice A.M. Shafiq and Justice Gopinath P. was hearing petitions challenging the common order of the Kerala Administrative Tribunal, which had held that direct recruitment is the only mode of recruitment to the post of lecturer in polytechnic colleges under the government of Kerala. The applicants before the tribunal were persons included in a ranked list prepared by the Kerala Public Service Commission for selection to the post of lecturers in technical streams in polytechnics under the Technical Education Department. They had approached the tribunal contending that in terms of the AICTE, regulations on pay scales, service conditions and minimum qualifications for appointment of teachers and other academic staff could be appointed only through direct recruitment. The tribunal accepted the contentions of the applicants before it and held that the recruitment to the post of lecturer could only be by direct recruitment. This finding of the tribunal is under challenge before the Kerala High Court. Elvin Peter PJ and Ayyappan Sankar, counsel appearing for the petitioners, submitted that the finding of the tribunal is absolutely unsustainable in law. They further contend that such stipulations in the AICTE regulations must not be taken to be binding or mandatory and cannot at any rate operate in the face of the special rules. Raghul Sudesh, counsel appearing for the contesting respondents, applicants before the tribunal, contended that act that the AICTE was authorized to stipulate that the appointment to the post of lecturer can only be by way of direct recruitment. While the High Court agreed with the central premise of the argument, the Court refused to allow a retrospective interpretation to be given to the AICTE regulations. The Court also noted that no provision has been pointed out from the AICTE Act to suggest that the AICTE could frame regulations with retrospective effect. However, all vacancies which arose after the date on which the 2019 regulations came into force shall be filled up only by direct recruitment in accordance with the stipulations contained in those regulations. Bureau Report.
The Madras High Court has settled a discord between celebrated music director Ilaiyaraaja and proprietors of Prasad Studios that would allow Ilaiyaraaja a day to mediate in the music room where he composed his song for the past 35 years as a condition to withdrawing cases filed over the denial of his access to the studio in 2019. Madras High Court resolved Ilaiyaraaja Prasad Studio dispute composer to meditate for a day in his former haunt. Here's a report.
On the Madras High Court's last working day, it recorded a settlement between Ilaiyaraaja and the proprietors of Prasad Studios that would allow the music maestro a day to meditate in the music room where he composed his songs for the past 35 years as a condition to withdraw cases filed over the denial of his access to the studio in 2019. Justice N. Satish Kumar recorded the following before disposing of the suit between Ilayaraja and Prasad Studios. That is, Ilayaraja will be allowed to enter the room where he composed his music for the last 35 years so that he can meditate for one day. The studio proprietors shall make an endeavor to see that nobody is present inside room. The room originally used by Ilayaraja now stood converted into an IT room, the court was apprised. When Ilayaraja is allowed inside the room, nobody will be permitted inside the room. When Ilayaraja is meditating inside the room, simultaneously the material belonging to him kept in a separate room at the same premises. At the time of Ilayaraja's entry to the premises, only 3 members would be permitted to accompany him. That is, 1 personal assistant and 2 music assistants besides the commissioner. Ilayaraja has told the court that he would withdraw all pending suits before the lower courts against the studio. The parties have agreed to bury their differences and give a quitus to the entire dispute existing between them. The date of entry into the premises shall be decided by the counsel appearing for the plaintiff and defendants in consultation with the advocate commissioner appointed by the court. Ilayaraja can enter the premises between 9 a.m. and 4 p.m. The time may be extended but not beyond 5 p.m. The Chennai Police Commissioner is to provide security and prevent crowds from causing any law and order problem when Ilayaraja undertakes the visit to Prasad Studio. The matter had reached court after Ilayaraja was denied access to the Prasad Studio citing renovation work in 2019. It is reported that the maestro's offer to release the premises was also rejected by the studio. Bureau report.
The Mumbai police told a local court in Mumbai that Partho Das Gupta arrested former CEO of Broadcast Audience Research Council in alleged connivance with another ex-senior BARC official and Republic TV editor-in-chief Arnab Goswami manipulated the television rating point of Republic TV and its Hindi arm. Here's a report.
The Mumbai police has claimed that there is evidence to prove that Republic TV editor-in-chief Arnab Goswami paid kickbacks in lakhs. Former senior official of Broadcast Audience Research Council Partho Das Gupta for manipulating the television rating point of Republic TV English and Republic Bharat news channels. Allegation has been made in a remand application seeking extension of police custody of Das Gupta, who was arrested on December 24, 2020 for his alleged involvement in the fake television rating point scam. In their application, the Mumbai police has claimed that during their investigation, they had come across evidence that showed Goswami had paid Das Gupta in return for his assistance in manipulating the TRP. The police said Arnav's further custodial interrogation was required to ascertain if more payments were made and if the same manipulation was done for other news channels too. It further alleged that Das Gupta, while serving as BARC CEO, was privy to confidential information on TRP ratings, fall channels, and a probe was on to find out if the same was revealed to others. It has alleged that they found at Das Gupta's house gold and other precious items allegedly purchased with the money received from Goswami. BARC is an organization responsible for installation of barometers, which is used to measure the TRP. It's the case of Mumbai police that Das Gupta has taken undue advantage of his position in BARC to carry out the illegal manipulation work. In order to show a higher viewership of Republic channels, Das Gupta ended up manipulating figures of the Times Now channel, which incidentally had high viewership. It has been contended. Das Gupta, taking advantage of his position and knowledge, falsely increased TRP ratings of some channels and reduced TRP ratings of other channels, the application alleges. In order to further investigate how the financial transactions happened and how the money was utilized, the police has sought for extension of custody. The Chief Metropolitan Magistrate at Esplanade, Mumbai, had remanded earlier Das Gupta to police custody till December 28, which got extended to December 30. Another accused, Priya Mukherjee, who is the COO of Republic TV, was granted anticipatory bail from Karnataka High Court as well as Mumbai Sessions Court. Romil Ramgriya, former Chief Operating Officer of the BARC, was also arrested in the TRP scam by the Mumbai police. He was granted bail by the Esplanade CMM on December 24th. Das Gupta is the 15th person to be arrested in case related to alleged raking of TRP of some news channels. Bureau report.
Underlining that National University of Study and Research in Law is a prime institution of the state of Jharkhand, the Jharkhand High Court recently conveyed its sentiments to the state government that the university needs regular support of the state government. Here's a report.
The Jharkhand High Court has stressed that National University of Study and Research in Law needs governmental support. The bench of Chief Justice Dr. Ravi Ranjan and Justice Sujit Narayan Prasad specifically observed it is high time that the state government should think over it, that for every small or big expenditure, the Vice Chancellor of the university should not be compelled to move. The matter before the court was related to the work of encircling the plot which lies on the other side of the road of the NURSL building with a boundary wall to avoid its encroachment. This work is to be done with state's assistance. Filing a counter affidavit, the government told the court that it is very much eager for development of the NURSL Ranji and has taken already steps for the same. To demonstrate the same, it stated that provision of 70 crore rupees has already been made and the process of releasing the sum to NURSL has been initiated. It was also submitted that government is also positive for contribution in development of NURSL Ranchi. The court remarked that the university, like the other universities and various other national law universities in other states, cannot thrive on the revenue collected through fees deposited by the students for its development and meeting the routine expenses. The court said, like other universities, certain grants on a regular basis, monthly or yearly, should be given by the state of Jharkhand. For example, there is a provision in the Patna University Act regarding meeting the budgetary expenses from the consolidated fund of the state. Importantly, the court said, the state government should come up with a policy for such type of support to the institution that this institution is beneficial for the state of Jharkhand, especially when we have been informed that 50% of the seats in the university has been reserved for the candidates of the state of Jharkhand. Bureau report.
That's all in Courts this week. Thank you for tuning in. Keep watching APN.
India Legal presents Court This Week.